Thank you, Maurice. Yes, I'm here with Michael Khodarkovsky, the executive director of the Grand Chess Tour, the mastermind behind the over-the-board chess here in the tour. Michael, first of all, welcome to the show. Tell us a little bit, how difficult was it to put this tour together this year?
Well, first of all, thank you, Cristian, for inviting me. And today is the last round, and we made it. Because, you know, actually it was a tour of 2020 that was postponed due to COVID, and obviously we didn't know what to expect. But we decided that we'll go forward with 2021 with the same setup of the tournaments that been set up for 2020. And I'm, you know, very grateful to our organizers all over the world that we organize these tournaments, and especially here, First Leg in Bucharest. They went above and beyond to organize this event with all details related to PCR tests for arrival, for departure, and protocols during the course of the tournament. And I believe that players appreciated this too. Of course, we have other difficulties to bring players to these events. There were some difficulties. For example, Dink was not able to come, although he was eager to come and play. Vishyanand could not come, but hopefully he will be playing in Zagreb. And all of a sudden, Richard Rapport, who already been preparing for the tour,
he got sick. Almost in Romania.
Almost there. He got sick literally like 2 days before the start of the tournament. Having said this, we had plan B and plan C and plan D, and Romanian players were able to come and actually showed
quite decent chess
and strengths and teeth. Absolutely. So therefore, they didn't look like newcomers.
Last minute newcomers.
And I believe that actually this tournament already showed that players are hungry to play in person. Public, even we have very limited access to the venue for public, but public also interested to come. We had interest not only from our major sponsor, Superbet, but some other local sponsors and government officials. So therefore, I think that overall, it was a great experience here at the First Leg, and we're looking forward to a similar experience in Paris, because you guys are flying tomorrow there.
Tomorrow, yeah.
And players will fly the day after tomorrow. And I've been in touch with our organizers in Paris.
And right now we're actually showing the schedule there. We see Paris, which is starting June 16, then Croatia, July 5 to 12. What can we expect in Croatia? You mentioned Vishyanand potentially coming. Who else?
Well, I think that most importantly, that we found actually interesting formula for this season, that we split Rapid and Blitz wild cards, and in Paris, former world champion Kramnik will be teaming up with French Grandmaster Bacro for Rapid and Blitz, and similar in Zagreb, Garry Kasparov will split wild cards with Croatian national Ivan Saric, as well as participation of the former world champion Vishyanand. I just want to remind our viewers that Garry and Vishy played world championship match in 1995 in New York, so they're legends.
Absolutely.
And absolutely it would be very interesting. But again, due to certain difficulties and withdrawals, we were able to include youngsters. And we have, in Zagreb, for instance, we have Jordan Ivan Saric and Jordan Van Forest, who actually won Weekend Z this year. So therefore, it would be interesting to see how players like Van Forest and Duda will try to play against legends like Vishy and Gary.
How important it is to give locals and youngsters specifically this chance to compete against the best players in the world?
I think it's a synergy between experience and young aspiring players to play the same tournament, at least to feel the touch of the mastery of the game. And it's very inspirational, I believe, and I think this formula should work very well in the future.
I have to say, it was so refreshing to see the influx of spectators here in Romania. Also, wanting to see the local players compete at the highest level. It was great to see that. What about next year? Do we have any plans for next year?
Well, we do have plans, and actually we basically already set up next year. We're just working on the calendar. Before I will tell you some piece of information about the next year, I must admit that next year is very difficult because due to COVID, the cycles for World Championship match were shifted. Therefore, next year, like first 3-4 months of the year, there will be three Grand Prix tournaments, qualifiers for the candidates. And the candidates will be first half a year. Then the Olympiad and also World Team Championship. So in order to navigate the calendar and insert our tournaments, although we have already requests and sponsors for more than five, we still, in order to accommodate calendar and not overweight the calendar for players, we decided to have five tournaments next year as well. Maybe we will include finals. So that must be seen, and this is the only question mark that we have for next year. However, I can tell you that we're coming back to Romania, and Superbet already confirmed that we will start 2022 here in Bucharest, and Superbet will be our major sponsor. We will have some new spots, and I just will give you a teaser that we will have spots in four European capitals.
Wow.
Plus the chess capital of the world, St. Louis.
That's huge news. It's going to be very difficult to put everything on the calendar, but I don't think there is better leadership in the world to get that done. Michael, thank you very much for doing everything for the fans, for the players, for the commentators. We thank you.
Thank you for having me.
Guys, back to you in the studio.